Good evening. I'm Jason Robards. Like you, I have been fascinated all my life by the art of magic. Tonight, I invite you to join me for a unique hour of fantasy and illusion. What we'll see are the style, grace, and mastery of a 24-year-old man who has been chosen by his peers as Magician of the Year and Entertainer of the Year. The illusions you will see him perform tonight are done without camera tricks. You are seeing the magic exactly as we in the studio can see it. It's very important to remember that, because one of the illusions to be attempted is the disappearance of a 7-ton Learjet. I use the word attempted because so far, it has not been accomplished successfully. Join me as we watch dramatic illusions unlike any you have ever seen on television, performed with a style unequaled by anyone in the world of magic. Here now, the fourth of our annual visits to the magic of David Copperfield.
For this past year, I've been trying to make this real jet disappear, unsuccessfully. Well, on tonight's show, in front of all of you, I get my last chance. My name is David Copperfield. Miss Catherine Bach.
Now, I'm so glad to be here. I can't wait to see what illusion you've come up with for us. One of those romantic boy meets girl, boy loses girl stories?
It's better than that.
And this is a wonderful costume. I love the neckline.
It's better than that.
Oh?
It comes with accessories.
Try this on.
Well, high necklines are nice, too.
It gets better. Try these on.
Ankle bracelets.
I get it. I'm going to be a prisoner at the mercy of some evil villain.
Better.
Maybe it's like the one where you find an old girlfriend's photo. Here, I brought one along.
Better.
But like a fading dream, I'm going to disappear, and all you'll have left is that photo in my memory.
Better, better, better.
Oh, David, I love it. Science fiction. I love those stories. Like the one where the girl saved you from the laser.
It's better.
David, that was so romantic, though. It tore me apart.
Now you're getting the idea.
Oh.
Thank you.
I can't think of anyone in television who equals the sheer dedication David Copperfield brings to his magic. For an entire year, David has been planning and preparing for tonight's show. David, don't you ever take any time off?
I try to, but even when I'm on vacation, I wind up searching for new illusions, like this one. When I was in France this past year, I came across this antique ballerina.
You mean that doll is magic?
In a way. It has these little beads that, when you pull them, make the ballerina come to life. Here, try it. Pull that one right there.
That one?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Ah, that's amazing. So the more beads you pull,
the more the doll can do. In fact, when I first got it, I spent hours trying to figure out all the different ways this doll could move, and it became so lifelike that it inspired our next illusion. In fact, if you'd be so kind, I'd love you to introduce it.
My pleasure, Dave. But first, let me remind you that the illusions you are about to see, like all the illusions on this show, are not performed by the camera. They are the creation and the result of the magic of David Copperfield.
Have you ever been in a group of people and felt like you just didn't fit in? When I was a kid, everybody thought I was a little strange because I loved magic so much. As I grew older, I learned that everybody at some time or another feels a little out of place, when all we really need is someone to show us that the things that make us different are also the things that make us special.
Thank you.
There will be more illusions, including David's attempt to make a 7-ton jet airplane disappear when we return for more of the magic of David Copperfield.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have some very distinguished guests in our audience here tonight. From the new CBS series, Mr. Merlin, please welcome Mr. Barnard Hughes, Mr. Clark Brandon, and Miss Elaine Joyce. Mr. Hughes, if you don't mind, I'd like to try an illusion with you.
Well, I tell you, I'll be playing a magician, a sorcerer this season, so why don't you use Elaine here, and I may pick up a few tips from you.
All right. Actually, I could do something if you let me borrow your ring.
Oh. Okay,
okay.
Trust you.
You do?
Your beautiful brown eyes.
Oh, thanks. You're not so bad yourself, you know. I'm going to trade you that ring for this rose.
Oh, beautiful.
Right now, I'd like to show you how special a ring can be.
Copperfield brings to his magic is not only performance, but also originality. Like most outstanding artists, his inspiration often springs from things that are part of his own life. He has drawn on one such experience for his next illusion.
Every year, my parents and grandparents take their vacation time to come out and see my show. Well, that doesn't seem like a very romantic vacation, and it started me thinking. Have you ever wondered whether your grandparents are still as romantic now as they were when they were your age? Well, I asked my grandparents, and with the help of my lovely guest, Audrey Landers, from the hit series Dallas, I'd like to share with you what their answer was.
Love isn't just for the young. It's for all who may wish upon a star. Love isn't just for the young. For true love doesn't ask how old you are. Doesn't matter if you're 20 or 92. You only need a heart to share. Then of course you need someone who feels like you and who answers every dream and prayer. Love isn't just for the young. Never fear, let the whole world know it's spring. For love isn't just for the young. And there's oh so much joy that it can bring. Yes, the gold may have turned to silver. But if you still have songs left unsung, just remember that love is for everyone. Love isn't just for the young. But if you still have songs left unsung, just remember that love is for everyone. Love isn't just
David, let me be sure that I have this straight. You are going to make $1 million jet airplane disappear?
I'm going to try.
And nobody has ever done anything that big before.
Including me. But first, I'd like to visit an old friend of mine in the audience. Or maybe I should say a young friend. Excuse me.
I'm still trying to figure out how a rabbit gets pulled out of a top hat, and this young man is going to make a 7-ton jet airplane disappear. Of course, the explanation is simple. It's magic.
Earlier in the show, I did an illusion with a bunch of kids, and one of them has become a big fan of magic. This is Joe.
Hi.
You've become pretty good friends, right?
Right.
And friends would do anything for each other, right?
Right.
So if I asked you to move to another seat so I could sit next to that pretty girl over there, you'd do it, right?
Wrong.
Oh, come on.
No way, Jose. Find your own date.
Okay. And it says that the star of the movie Tie Next. I'm really excited. Please welcome Miss Bo Derek. Bo Derek's not here. Star of the movie Tarzan. Must be Richard Harris. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Richard. Not Richard. Richard Harris. Well, who's the star of the movie Tarzan? I'm gonna need you to jump up here on the stool, okay? Good. It's very easy. Come here, just jump. Jump right up there. That's it, just jump. A little higher. Let me just show you here. Stand like this. Stand right there. Just watch me. Watch, okay? Just jump up here.
That's funny. That's pretty funny.
Come on. Come on. Get up on the stool here. I'll hold it for you. That's it. Ladies and gentlemen, this is CJ. It's an honor to have you on my show. I'd like to shake your hand. That's close enough. CJ, confidentially, mammal to mammal, what was it like working with Bo Derek? That good, huh? I got something great, too. How'd you like to see a card trick? I thought you would. But before I show you the card trick, I'd like to dazzle this audience with some expert card manipulation. These card fans took 15 years of... Cards go up the sleeve, stop them. Let's get right to the trick. CJ, I've made a prediction. And believe it or not, the card that you select will match my prediction. Okay? No. Okay, CJ, I'm gonna need you to pick a card. Come on, pick a card. It's easy, guy. Just take one. That's it. Take a card. That's it. Now just show it to the camera. I don't want to see it. You could have picked any of these other cards. Now hold on to it. I'm going to need you to look at that card closely, all right? Oh, no problem. Here. Put these on. Have you done this before? You have? Well, you're going to do it again. I'm going to take the car without looking at it and place it in my pocket here. Now, CJ, what would you say if the card that you selected matches my prediction? Everybody's a critic. CJ, I need your help. I need you to really concentrate on your card. Really think hard. Really think. Think really hard. That's enough thinking. CJ, see that picture over there? Watch. Isn't that great? No? You trying to tell me that's not your card? It is your card. It's not your card. It's not the eight of diamonds. It's the four of diamonds. How am I going to get out of this one? Very funny, very funny. CJ, I'd like to remind you this is my show. Whose show do you think it is? You're probably right. CJ, see the card over there? Watch the diamonds. You're super. You know I have a hot tub.
What we're about to see is the culmination of a year's planning, experimentation, and rehearsal. And in all that time, David has yet to complete one successful run-through. Adverse weather conditions, including strong airport winds, have constantly hindered his attempts. The entire illusion has been completely revamped in the past week, and what you will see tonight has never been completely tested. David Copperfield is going to try to make a 7-ton jet disappear. Because of the magnitude of the illusion and the uncertainty of its success, what we are about to see is one of the great moments in the history of magic. Never before has anyone tried to make anything this big disappear. Time now for the biggest challenge ever faced by the magic of David Copperfield.
And I'm at an airport right outside our studios. Now, the reason I'm at an airport is because the size of our next illusion would be impossible to perform indoors. Now, I want to remind all of you that everything you see tonight is exactly the way you would see it if you were standing right here with me. Now, what you see behind me is a 10-foot-high scaffolding. This will form into an enclosure of three walls. The fourth wall is made of cloth, and it's lying on the runway right out there in front, ready to be raised into position. Now I'd like to throw it to Sammy Jackson so he could tell us a little bit about the plane itself. Sammy?
Thank you very much, Susan. As Jason mentioned earlier, this is the largest object that anyone has ever attempted to vanish. The weight is an incredible 7 tons, and the price is equally incredible, over $2 million.
In addition to this wall, the plane will be surrounded by a human chain. 50 spectators linked together, making the disappearance of this plane, in my opinion, virtually impossible. There you can see them now, taking their position right around the plane. That switch is a new addition. It controls the lights at the back of the enclosure. When the translucent front wall is up, it will backlight the plane and the people surrounding it. Casting their silhouette. where it's on the translucent front wall so that we can see the plane right up until the moment that it vanishes.
I'm sure everyone has a few questions regarding the surroundings or even the airplane itself. So we've invited the vice president of Gates Learjet Corporation, Jim Greenwood, and also the owner of this particular aircraft, Mr. Clay Lacey. Hi, gentlemen.
Good evening.
First of all, Jim, has this airplane been tampered with in any way?
Absolutely not.
So it is a genuine aircraft.
It's completely operational, Sammy, in every way.
Except for one thing.
What's that?
I've drained all the fuel. He couldn't even fly this aircraft out.
Gentlemen, I'm here with Airport Maintenance Supervisor Dick Waters. And Dick, I have a few questions for you. This runway that you and I and, of course, the plane are on, now, it doesn't open up or have any elevators?
No, that's correct. This is a solid sheet of asphalt, and it has a Conrock base.
Okay. The plane can't go up. Can't go down, right?
That's correct.
Okay, and it is completely out in the open with 100 feet around it in all directions?
Correct.
Okay, thank you. Straps are being attached to the plane now to lock it into place. Blindfolded for a very obvious reason, to protect this, the mystery of the world's biggest and most expensive illusion. Now, I'd like to remind all of you that David's magic is performed with absolutely no camera tricks. The illusion that you are watching right now at home is exactly the way he is doing it now. Ladies and gentlemen, David Copperfield. There were no camera tricks. The illusion was actually performed right here.
I couldn't believe it. If I'm sitting at home, I could think of some way to get out of it. But I was right here, and there's no way that plane could have left.
Well, it did.
Ma'am, was that plane here just
it
a moment
sure
ago?
It sure was.
What happened to it?
It disappeared.
What about you, sir?
It's just amazing.
What happened to the airplane?
I don't know. It went.
It went.
How did you feel?
It was thrilling. It was shocking.
Yeah.
I got chills.
What did you think when they dropped and you took down your blindfold and it was gone?
It was incredible.
Absolutely incredible.
and illusions with you. I'd also like you to thank my guests, Jason Robards, Susan Anton, Audrey Landers, Catherine Bach, the paintings of Patrick Nagel, and you too, CJ. Now tell me, wasn't I more fun to work with than Bo Derek?
Appearing in tonight's cast, Maury Boyan, Robin Daly, Lynn Eric, Susan Carr George, Andre Gower, Joel Graves, Sammy Jackson, Sarah Miles, Eric Orson, Leota Richards, and musical arrangements by Sid Feld.